friends, I'm Katie, and this is Catherine the 19th. Welcome back to Creator Club. On this week's episode of Creator Club, I'm talking all about my workflow for creating YouTube videos. One of the biggest challenges that so many people come across when trying to make YouTube content consistently is that it takes a long time to make a YouTube video. However, this can be improved if you have an efficient workflow that helps you film and edit your YouTube videos faster. So today I'm going to talk about my workflow for creating YouTube videos, and hopefully it's useful to you in creating a more efficient workflow for yourself. My YouTube workflow is structured in monthly chunks. This is a system that I developed when I first started daily vlogging. Creating videos on a Monday to Friday basis is a lot of content to try to keep organized, so I decided that I wanted to create a monthly system for keeping all of my footage, final exports, and project files organized. I store all of my files on an external hard drive. I find this keeps me more organized and my computer running faster. Inside of my YouTube folder, I have a daily vlogs folder that contains all of the source footage and other metadata around my vlogs. I have a folder for each month that I label with the number and then the name of the month. And within that folder, I have three folders. This is becoming like folderception. I know, there's a lot of layers. In each of those folders, I have one for the project file, one for the source footage, and one for the exports. My process usually begins with importing my footage into the source footage folder. I have a folder within that for each day of daily vlogging, which I number by the number of vlog within that month. At the beginning of each month, I also create a new project file in Premiere, so that means that every vlog that I create within a given month is within one Premiere file, which means that I have sequences for each vlog within that file. Honestly, when I first started this process, I was worried that it would make editing really slow, but it turns out that it actually doesn't slow Premiere down that much at all, and it becomes really easy then to kind of throw back to clips from previous vlogs, especially if you do a little preview at the end of each vlog for a previous vlog to encourage your viewers to watch it. It becomes really, really easy. You can just copy and paste an exact little sequence out of a previous vlog and put it into your current one, and you don't have to worry about like importing files from some folder buried deep on your computer. So in terms of my actual editing workflow, it begins like this. After I have a new file created for that month, I'll import the day's footage to Premiere in a new bin, which is titled for that day. Moving forward, I usually just start editing in chronological order. This will really depend on the day though, because sometimes while I'm filming a vlog during the day, I'll think of a way that I want to structure it and a way that I want to edit it to create the story. But for the most part, I just start with the first clip that I filmed and then move forward from there, piecing it together until I have a structure that I'm happy with. Often though, I will create a clip at the very end of the day where I sort of do a narration for everything that's happened throughout the day. And so if that's the case, I'll start with that one and then structure everything around that. It really depends on your own personal preference and how you like to create a vlog. For me, it really varies depending on the day and the content of that day and how I want to present it. Once I have a general structure though for what I want the video to look like, then I'll go back in with music and I'll adjust all the audio levels and all of that kind of thing to fit with the music that I want to add to the vlog. As for music, I usually find it on YouTube or SoundCloud or in the YouTube Creative Commons library. For the most part, I try to find royalty-free music, but the odd time I will use copyrighted music, but just 30 seconds of it, and then YouTube Content ID won't notice it. That's a little bit of a sketchy thing to do, but come on, everybody does. During my editing process, I usually try to look for a good thumbnail that I can use, and I'll just bring my cursor over the frame that I want to use and then press the little camera capture button in the video editing panel, and then that will save a JPEG to my hard drive that I can go back in and edit later in Photoshop to create a thumbnail for the video. Finally, once I've finished all of my edits, I'll go ahead and export the video. I do this by going to File, Export. I just export it right in Premiere because I usually don't have a video to edit immediately afterwards. If you do though, you can use Adobe Media Encoder instead. Before I do the final export, I will go in and change the frame rate because I usually film in 60 frames per second, but I want to export it in 30. That way any slow motion that I've used will work. I also will go in and change the name from April underscore whatever number to vlog number, whatever number of vlog it is. I'm up to like 57 at this point, I think. After exporting, it's just a matter of uploading it to YouTube and designing the thumbnail. Usually I'll start uploading the video and then go into Photoshop and edit my thumbnail. All I really do is adjust the exposure and the curves a little bit to make it pop more, maybe add a touch of vibrance to it just to bring out the colors, and then I'll add my blue border just to make it match with the rest of the videos on my channel. And that, my friends, is just a taste of my YouTube workflow. I hope this video was helpful for you and gave you a little bit of insight into how I make YouTube videos in a somewhat consistent and efficient way, and hopefully it helped you think of ways that you can make your YouTube workflow a little bit more efficient. I'm always looking for more suggestions for videos that you want to see. In my last video where I talked about how to vlog, a number of you expressed interest in seeing a video about my YouTube workflow, and so I made it. So please let me know in the comments below any videos that you'd like to see me make all around these creative topics, because I would love to make them for you. Of course, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. I always appreciate the support. And comment below any suggestions for future videos. Also, please make sure you hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss out on any of my future daily vlogs, Creator Club videos, or other videos about photography, videography, and design. As always, I love you all. I hope you're following your dreams. And always remember to keep creating. I'll see you tomorrow.